DJ Event Planner will change the way you manage and run your business. Streamline all of your procedures and software into one easy-to-manage system. DJ Event Planner, the ultimate online planning tool.
Hey everybody, this is Dan Cheney for the Music Charts Archive Show on DJN TV, and this week we're going back to the week of July 29th, 1995, and I've got a little special guest here with me today. We record here in Minnesota, but my daughter's in town from Cincinnati. Danica, say hi, Danica.
Hello.
And she's going to go through the list with me today, so let's get started.
For number 10, we have Runaround by Blues Traveler.
Yes, we do. This was the breakthrough hit for the band, and it would peak at number 8. It was from their album 4, and it won the group a Grammy for Best Rock Performance by a Duo or Group. And the song was written by frontman John Popper.
Number 9 was Have You Ever Really Loved a Woman by Bryan Adams.
Yes, it was. And this song was on its way down the chart after spending 5 weeks at number 1. It was his fourth and final number one song, and it was written for the movie Don Juan DeMarco with Johnny Depp. And it was nominated for Best Original Song at the Oscars that year, but it lost out to Colors of the Wind from Pocahontas.
Number 8 was Total Eclipse of the Heart by Nikki French.
Yep, this dance cover version of the number one song by Bonnie Tyler from 84 spent 11 weeks in the top 10 and peaked at number 2. Now, this was the only chart single in the U.S. for the English singer, but she did have some minor hits in her native U.K.
Now, number 7 was Water Runs Dry by Boyz II Men.
Yep, this was the 7th top 10 hit for the vocal group from Philly, and like Total Eclipse, it also peaked at number 2. Now, this was the 4th single from their 3rd studio album, and the song was written and produced by Babyface.
Number 6 was I Can Love You Like That by All For One.
Yep, the 3rd top 10 hit for the vocal group, and 2 months earlier, it was a number one country song for John Michael Montgomery. Now, Montgomery's version did not make the pop chart, but the All For One version ended up peaking at number 5.
Tonight's show is brought to you by Electra Voice, DJ Event Planner, DJ Trivia, Odyssey Innovative Designs and Cases, NLFX Professional, Promo Only, and the DJ and TV Insiders.
Welcome back to the Music Charts Archive Show. I'm Dan Cheney, and today we're looking back at the songs from the week of July 29th, 1995. I'm joined today by my daughter, Danica. In 1995, I was about 30 years old, and my daughter, Danica, was actually about -1 at the time. So she brings a lot of experience to this list. Let's get back into the chart.
Number 5 was Kiss from a Rose by Seal.
Now, this song was on its way to becoming Seal's first and only number one song. It was on his 1994 self-titled album, but it gained popularity, actually, when it was included on the Batman Forever soundtrack. Now, at the Grammys, it won Record of the Year, Song of the Year, and Best Pop Male Vocal Performance.
Number 4 was Boombastic by Shaggy.
Yep, and this was Shaggy's first top 10 hit, and it peaked at number 3. It was a number 1 R&B song and hit number 1 in several other countries. It was its popularity was aided by being featured in a Levi's jeans commercial, and was it also a double-sided hit with a remake of In the Summertime as the other song.
So number 3 was Don't Take It Personal by Monica.
Yep, this was the first hit single for the R&B singer, and she was just 14 at the time. It peaked at number 2, and it was a number 1 R&B hit. Now, her next song, Before You Walk Out of My Life, also hit number 1 on the R&B chart, making Monica the youngest person to ever have 2 consecutive number 1 R&B songs. Number 2.
The number 2 was One More Chance, Stay With Me by the Notorious B.I.G.
Yep, a remixed version of the song from his Ready to Die album, and it featured his wife, Faith Evans. The song entered the chart all the way up at number 5, which at the time tied a record for the highest debuting song on the charts. He actually tied a record with Michael and Janet Jackson, who just the week earlier also debuted at number 5 with their song Scream. And going to number 1.
So number one is Waterfalls by TLC.
Yep, the song was from their second album, Crazy Sexy Cool, and that album produced 4 top 5 hits and 2 number 1 songs. The other number one song from this album was Creep. Now, Waterfalls spent 7 weeks at number one and was ranked as the second biggest song of the year. It was nominated for Record of the Year at the Grammys, but lost out to Seal's Kiss from a Rose. But it did win Video of the Year at the Video Music Awards for MTV. This song is noted for its socially conscious lyrics, and it's supposedly the first number one song to ever mention AIDS in one of its verses. So that's it. Those were the top 10 songs from the week of July 29th, 1995. Be sure you give the video a thumbs up and let us know in the comments which of these songs are some of your favorites. I think my favorite's probably Kiss from a Rose by Seal. I like Seal's first album and some other songs on there. And you like?
I like Waterfalls by TLC. And then I guess I'll sneak in Boombastic just
because
of childhood memories.
Sentimental.
Yes.
Yeah, just taking you back.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of Bryan Adams' ballads most of the time. Like, I really like Heaven and Everything I Do It For You. But for some reason, this Have You Ever Really Loved a Woman kind of fell flat for me. I just wasn't a big fan of that one for some reason. But I like Bryan Adams' other stuff, just didn't like that one. Anyway, so that's it. So that's our show for this week. Be sure you join us again next time. I'm Dan Chaney. And
I'm Danica Chaney.
Yep. And be sure you join us again for the Music Charts Archive show on DJN TV, and we'll see you next time.